we can describe here, how we can describe a chemical reaction and what are the indications of a chemical reaction. First one is evolution of heat, light and sound. Then production of gas. Next is formation of a precipitate. Then color change. And let us see signs of chemical reactions. Here there are 5 main signs that indicate a chemical reaction has taken place. First one is change in color, then change in odor, then production of new gases or vapor. Next one is input or release of energy, and last one is difficult to reverse chemical equations. Here we have to depict the kind of reactants and products and their relative amounts in a reaction. Here when aluminium reacts with oxygen gas, it forms aluminium oxide. Here aluminium and oxygen acts as reactants, while aluminium oxide is a product. Then you will see some other reactions. Here 4 aluminium atoms, when reacts with 3 oxygen molecules, they yield 2 molecules of aluminium oxide. Or 4 aluminium moles reacts with 3 oxygen moles and yield 2 moles of aluminium oxide. Then what are the chemical equations? Because the same atoms are present in a reaction at the beginning, that is in case of reactants, and at the end, that is in case of products, the amount of matter in a system does not change. Then what is the law of conservation of matter? You can understand with the help of diagram. Now let us see chemical equations. Because of the principle of the conservation of matter, an equation must be balanced. It must have the same number of atoms of the same kind on both sides. Then what are the characteristics of chemical equations? First one is, the equation must represent known facts. Next, the equation must contain the correct formulas for the reactants and products. And last is, the law of conservation of mass must be satisfied. Here, what are the reactants? The substances that exist before a chemical change or reaction are called as reactants. And what are products? The new substances that are formed during the chemical changes are called as products. Here the chemical equation indicates the reactants and products of a reaction. A word equation describes chemical change using the names of the reactants and products. Here methane plus oxygen gives carbon dioxide plus water, where methane and oxygen acts as reactant, while carbon dioxide and water acts as product. then what are the unbalanced and balanced equations? Here you can see in the diagram, the first equation is unbalanced, while the second equation is balanced. Then visualizing a chemical reaction. Here 10 moles of sodium plus 5 moles of chlorine will give how much mole of sodium chloride? How much? 10 moles. 10 moles of sodium chloride. Then what is the meaning of chemical formula? You can see in the diagram. Then balancing chemical equations. What is a balanced equation? One equation in which the number of atoms of each element as a reactant is equal to the number of atoms of that element as a product. And what is the relationship between the conservation of mass and the facts that a balanced equation will always have the same number of atoms of each element on both sides of an equation? Here we have to determine whether the following equation is balanced or not. Then how we can balance the chemical equation? First of all, we have to write a word equation for the reaction. Then write the correct formulas for all reactants and products. Then determine the coefficients that make the equation balanced. Let us see some other examples. Is this equation balanced? Yes or no? What are reactants? The substances that exist before a chemical change or reaction are called as reactants. Then what are products? The new substances that are formed during the chemical changes are called as products. Here, the chemical equation indicates the reactants and products of a reaction. What are word equations? A word equation describes chemical change using the names of the reactants and products. Here, methane plus oxygen gives carbon dioxide plus water. Methane and oxygen acts as reactant, while carbon dioxide and water acts as product. CH4 plus O2 gives CO2 plus H2O. Then let us see unbalanced and balanced equation. Here the first equation is unbalanced, as in the reactants there are two molecules of hydrogen and chlorine, while in products there are only one molecule of hydrogen and chlorine. So the equation is unbalanced. Then in the next reaction, it is a balanced equation. Here in reactants there are two molecules of hydrogen and chlorine. Also in products also there are two molecules of hydrogen and chlorine, so the reaction is balanced. Equation is balanced. Then here we can visualize a chemical reaction. Let us see here, there are 10 moles of sodium which reacts with 5 moles of chlorine. Then how much moles of sodium chloride we will get? Can you think? Here we will get 10 moles of sodium chloride. Then let us see meaning of chemical formula. Here chemical symbol is H2O. That means one molecule of water and composition is two hydrogen atoms and one oxygen atoms. While in next, that is 2H2O, there are two molecules of water. Here the composition is four hydrogen atoms and two oxygen atoms. In third case, here one molecule of hydrogen peroxide. Here there are two hydrogen atoms and two oxygen atoms. Then how we can balance chemical equations? Here what is balanced equation? One in which the number of atoms of each element as a reactant is equal to the number of atoms of that element as a product. Here you have to determine whether the following equation is balanced or not. Then for balancing chemical equations, we have to write a word equation for the reaction. Then write the correct formulas for all reactants and products. Then determine the coefficients that make the equation balanced. Here we can see some other examples for balancing the chemical equations. You have to tell whether the equations are balanced or not. Then here you can see the 2 to the left of NO and NO2 refers to the number of molecules present in the balanced equation. It is a multiplier for every atom in the molecule. The subscript 2 in O2 and NO2 refers to the number of atoms of this type that are present in each molecule or ionic compound. Now there are some guidelines for balancing chemical equations. First is polyatomic ions first. Then even or odd. First of all, make all even. Third one is you have to balance. Fourth, single element last. Example, need 13 oxygen atoms, multiply by O2 is equal to 13. So 13 by 2 in this way you can balance the reaction. Here you can see ammonium phosphate and reacts with magnesium hydroxide. It gives magnesium phosphate plus what? Can you guess? It will give ammonium hydroxide, that is NH4OH. And in this way we can balance the reaction. Now you can try balance this reaction. So write a word equation for the reaction. This is the reaction. Chlorine plus sodium bromide gives bromine plus sodium chloride. Then write the correct formulas for all reactants and products. That is Cl2 plus NaBr gives Br2 plus NaCl. then determine the coefficients that make the equation balanced. Here Cl2 plus twice NaBr gives Br2 plus twice NaCl. Once again, write a word equation for the reaction, that is aluminum sulfate plus calcium chloride gives calcium sulfate. Then write the correct formulas for all reactants and products, that is Al2SO4 by 3 plus CaCl2 gives CaSO4 plus AlCl3. Then determine the coefficients that make the equation balanced. Here CH4 plus twice O2 gives CO2 plus twice H2O. So in case of reactants, there are 4 hydrogen atoms, 4 oxygen atoms and 1 carbon atom. Also in case of products, there are 4 hydrogen atoms, 4 oxygen atoms and 1 carbon atom. Here the reactants are carbon and oxygen, which gives products, that is carbon dioxide. In case of reactants, there is 1 carbon atom and 2 oxygen atoms. Also in case of products, there is 1 carbon atom and 2 oxygen atoms. Here hydrogen, when reacts with oxygen, gives water. Here in case of reactants, there are 2 hydrogen atoms and 2 oxygen atoms, and in case of products, there are 2 hydrogen atoms and 1 oxygen atom. So it is unbalanced. Now we can show phases in chemical equations. Solid phase, the substance is relatively rigid and has a definite volume and shape, that is sodium chloride. Liquid phase, the substance has a definite volume but is able to change shape by flowing, that is water. In gaseous phase, the substance has no definite volume or shape and it shows little response to gravity, that is chlorine. Let us see some of the additional symbols used in chemical equations. First symbol shows that it yields, indicates result of reactions. Second symbol used to indicate a reversible reaction. Then this is a symbol for a reactant or product in the solid state, also used to indicate a precipitate. This symbol shows alternative to S but used only to indicate a precipitate. This symbol shows a reactant or product in the liquid state. And this symbol shows a reactant or product in an aqueous solution, that is dissolved in water. And this symbol shows a reactant or product in the gaseous state. Here you can see some of the solubility ionic equations. Now let us see types of chemical reactions. First one is synthesis, that is combination reaction. Here A plus B gives AB. Second one is decomposition reaction. Here AB gives A plus B. Then single replacement reaction. Here A plus BC gives AC plus B. Then double replacement reaction. Here AB plus CD gives AD plus CB. Then neutralization reaction. Here HX plus BOH gives BX plus HOH. Then combustion reaction. Here CH plus O2 gives CO2 plus H2O. Then polymerization. Here, polymer gives many monomers. First of all, let us see synthesis reaction or combination reaction, in which A plus B gives AB. Then once again, decomposition reaction, in which AB gives A plus B. Then single replacement reaction, in which A plus BC gives AC plus B. Then double replacement reaction, in which AB plus CD gives AD plus CB. Then neutralization reaction, in which HX plus BOH gives BX plus HOH. Then combustion reaction, in which CH plus O2 gives CO2 plus H2O. Then polymerization, in which polymer gives many monomers. Here in this reaction, one molecule of nitrogen plus three molecules of hydrogen gives two molecules of ammonia. Then in this synthesis reaction, two molecules of sodium plus chlorine gas gives sodium chloride. So what is general formula here? The general form, A plus B gives AB, that is element plus element gives compound. Then formation of a solid. Here lead chloride plus potassium iodide will give potassium chloride plus lead iodide. Then we'll see decomposition reaction. Now let us see single and double replacement reaction. In this, Mg plus CuSO4 gives MgSO4 plus Cu. And in next reaction, CaCO3 plus twice HCl gives CaCl2 plus H2CO3. So first is single replacement reaction and second is double replacement reaction. Here the potassium reacts with water. This is double replacement reaction and this is the synthesis reaction, in which CO2 plus H2O gives C6H12O6 plus O2. Next one is formation of a putter, in which nitrogen gas plus oxygen gives water. Then formation of salt, in which Na plus Cl2 gives NaCl, that is sodium chloride. Now we see decomposition reactions. Here hydrogen peroxide gives water plus oxygen. Then here electrolysis of water, in which water when electrified gives hydrogen plus oxygen. Then nitrogen triiodide gives nitrogen plus iodine. Now we have to predict if these reactions will occur or not. Let us see first reaction. Now tell me, can magnesium replace aluminium in this reaction? Yes. Why? Because magnesium is more reactive than aluminium. Then in this next reaction, Can aluminum replace magnesium? Yes or no? No. Why? Aluminum is less reactive than magnesium. Therefore, no reaction will occur. Single replacement reactions. Here in first reaction, can Fe replace Cu? Yes. And in second reaction, can zinc replace hydrogen? Yes. Can bromine replace chlorine? No. There will be no reaction. How would you prepare potassium nitrate using a double replacement reaction? Here K plus NO3 gives KNO3 plus water.